Today's second lecture in insect ecology and integrated pest management is effects of abiotic factors and biotic factors on insect population. Then the two different factors affect the insect life or survival. Biotic factors means all living things, and abiotic factors means non-living thing, means dependent and independent factors. And firstly, discuss with effects of abiotic factors on insect population. Means the abiotic factors are different components affect the insect survival. Means their feeding habits, then survival, mating. Is all the activities affected by the abiotic factors. These factors are also known as the physical factors, or non-living and density independent factors. In effects of abiotic factors on insect population, means what type of effects produce on insect life or insect survival. Then these abiotic factors further classified into physical factors, then nutritional factors, then host associated factors. These are the three major categories classified the abiotic factors. Firstly, discuss with the physical factors. These physical factors include the temperature, moisture, light, air, and water current. And edaphic factors, they influence the development, longevity, and reproduction, and fecundity of insects. This is the all factors. They are very variable in temperature, means decreasing, increasing, then moisture decreasing, increasing, light intensity, then air flow and water and soil factor. This is the all factors affect the insect survival. Means particular insect favor the particular range of temperature as well as moisture and particular type of soil for their better development. This the all factor changes then affect the insect all activities. Then population density fluctuated depending on weather condition. Means changing the weather condition, they affect the insect population. Means death increase rate or natality or mortality. This extreme weather causes the mortality. Means extremely changes the, it means increasing the temperature, then some insect dead, or decreasing temperature, also some insect dead. But particular range is the favorable for the insect development or better growth. Then firstly discuss with temperature. Then means the temperature increasing and decreasing, the hot type of effect produced on the insect life. Then insect are pycnothermics. Is an objective type question for examination purpose. Is the insect are pycnothermic. Means do not have the mechanism regulate the their body temperature. That the insect does not regulate their body temperature. Then next, temperature maintenance is classified three major groups. Means pycnothermic, then warm blooded is also called as homeothermic or endothermic. Then socio homeothermic. These are three major categories of insect regulate their body temperature. Then warm-blooded is also called as homeothermic or endothermic. Then animal maintain the body temperature constant irrespective of the atmospheric temperature. For example, mammals and birds, their body temperature is as compared to the environmental temperature range or atmospheric temperature range. Then third type is socio-homeothermic animals. For example, or ideal example is a honeybee. Can able to maintain their body temperature slightly above the atmospheric temperature or increase their body temperature as compared to atmospheric temperature range. Then optimum temperature for the normal development. All insect require the specific range for their better development means or complete their activities or survival activities. Then this optimum temperature range for require for better development or normal development of every insect is 10 degree to 35 degree Celsius, and is this temperature range is known as zone of optimum or normal development. This is the temperature range every insect develop better development or occurs in particular range. Then the different temperature range for and zone of temperature range, zone of fatal low temperature means minus 40 degree Celsius to minus 5 degree Celsius temperature range. This is called zone of fatal temperature range. Then second zone of inactive due to the low temperature means minus 5 degrees Celsius to 10 degrees Celsius. This is the range is the zone of inactive due to the low temperature. That type of temperature range the maximum insect affect their life or development. Then third zone of effective temperature means every insect prefer the particular range means 10 degrees Celsius to 35 degrees Celsius is the good for the insect better development. Then next zone of inactive due to the high temperature range means increasing temperature many insect stop their life or undergo the different condition means activation hibernation. Increasing temperature means insect suspend their life cycle in high temperature. In 35 degrees Celsius to 50 degrees Celsius temperature is the high temperature or zone of inactive temperature range. Then last zone of fatal high temperature means more than 50 degrees Celsius to 60 degrees Celsius. But some insects survive in that particular zone of temperature range. Then preferred or optimum temperature at which the normal physiological activities or normal physiological activity takes place insect survival and development at this specific temperature range means 10 degrees Celsius to 30 degrees Celsius temperature range is the preferred or optimum temperature range. Then upper lethal limit means some insect die but in a store product insect survive in up to the 60 degrees Celsius temperature range. Then low lethal limits means below freezing point. The some insect, for example, snowfly survival in low lethal limits or below freezing temperature range. Then at low temperature, the low temperature insect take more day to complete their life cycle. Means in cold season or decreasing temperature, temperature insect require the maximum days for complete their life cycle or complete their metamorphosis is called as hibernation. Means if the insect suspend their life cycle in cold season or winter season is called hibernation. Then hibernating stages in larva or pupa they require the maximum day to complete their every instar. Then at high temperature means estivation insect suspend their life cycle in high temperature or summer season is called estivation. If they take less day for complete their life cycle as compared to hibernation. Hibernation require maximum days for complete their life cycle. Then in summer season or increasing temperature, insect complete their life cycle in short or few days. Then during this period, there is the temporary development arrested, the metabolic activities suspended. This particular stages. Means hibernation and estivation, the insect temporarily suspend their metabolic activities. When the temperature is favorable, they are resume the active. And, for example, a grasshopper, they means effects of the temperature or variation of temperature, they affect the insect life. For example, a grasshopper lay egg 20 to 30 times more at 32 degrees Celsius as compared to 22 degrees Celsius. Means 32 degrees Celsius is the this temperature range, the grasshopper lay maximum egg as compared to 22 degrees Celsius temperature. Then oviposition of bed bug inhabit at the at 8 to 10 degrees Celsius temperature range. Then early shoot borer of sugarcane attack more in high temperature range. In sugarcane planting area, they in summer season observe the maximum deadhead symptom. That's why the early should borer preferred the high temperature range. Then larval period of sugarcane internode borer very short 62 to 24 days in summer, prolonged 141 to 171 days in winter. This is the difference means increasing temperature the larva complete their life in 60 to 24 days in summer. In summer and in winter season, this internode borer larva require the 141 to 171 days for complete their life cycle or complete their development. Then swarm migration of the locust at 17 to 20 degree Celsius. And next factor is moisture or humidity. Our next parameter is moisture or humidity. The moisture is required for every organisms for their better development. Is the moisture required for the metabolic reactions and transportation of the salt in insect body? Means it regulate temperature as well as its translocation the salt as well as inner important materials. Then other adaptations like morphological, physiological prevent the moisture losses in insects. This term we have seen in last course in insect morphology and insect morphology. The insect integument bearing the different layers. The wax layer is a major or important layer to protect the moisture or conserve the moisture in insects. Then moisture scarcity leads to dehydration and death of the insect, but very rare. In moisture scarcity, very rarely insect die. Then excessive moisture can be helpful in different ways or following ways. First, affected normal development and activity of the insect, means increasing moisture as well as decreasing moisture. These are both conditions is affect the insect life and encourage the disease causing pathogens. This is increasing moisture, the disease causing pathogens on insects like white halo fungus or fungal entomopathogenic fungi require the maximum moisture. They cause the diseases on insects. For example, white halo fungus, Verticillium lacinia on coffee green scale, means Coccus viridis, they require high relative humidity for the multiplication and spread. Entomopathogenic fungi require the maximum relative humidity to produce the disease on coffee green scale insects. And second example, high relative humidity induces the brown plant hopper in rice. The brown plant hopper is a pest of rice and aphid in other crops. This is a brown plant hopper and aphids require the maximum or high relative humidity for further developments. Then termites prefer high humidity. Means termites prefer the 90 to 95% relative humidity. Then next parameter, light. The basic process of food manufacture in nature is accomplished under the visible rays, especially the blue and red. Is the blue and red rays is important for the manufacturing the food. This is visible length is the wavelength of 400 to 760 nanometer are in visible range. The following properties of the light influence the insect life. In the different ways the insect life affected by lights. First, intensity and illumination. Then quality and wavelength and duration or photoperiodism. First, photoperiodism. What is meant by photoperiodism? The response of organism to environmental rhythm of light and darkness. This insect responds to lightness and darkness. Then movement of animal in response to lights, means insect response to light, positive or negative response, means light, some insect attract toward the lights or away from the lights. This is a positive and negative response. This is the response of insects toward the lights is called phototactics. Then photoperiod influences the induction of the dipause. Dipause means arresting stages or favorable condition insects suspend their life in most insects. In some examples, the long day during the embryonic development caused the adult to lay the dipausing eggs in Bombax mori, the mulberry moth. Then seasonal dimorphism occurs in aphids due to the change in photoperiod, means a long day and short day. This is the seasonal dimorphism, means sexual and asexual reproduction. This is in the short day, the sexual form of aphids. Then, short day, sexual form, and long day, asexual, means parthenogenetically reproduction. Then like some insects are active in night time. It's called as nocturnal insects or nocturnal condition. Then some insect active during daytime is a diurnal type of insects like butterflies, and nocturnal type moth. And some insect active during dawn or dusk condition or evening time is a crepuscular condition. And next example, fruit flies lay eggs in dark, or maximum lay eggs in dark condition. In Lepidopteran like cotton bollworm, red hairy caterpillar, oviposit in dark condition. Next, dusk or evening time means crepuscular type is the most usual time for the flight and population for the moth. This is the crepuscular condition or evening light, the maximum moth active at particular condition. The dusk is the most usual time for the emergence of the winged white ant. Then grub of Trochoderma species show the negative reaction to lights, means away from the lights, is the photo negative response of insects. Then some insects are able to detect the polarized lights, means to detect the light orientation. The ideal example for polarized light insects is the honeybee. Can perceive the degree of the polarization of light in a different region of the sky and use this information in combination with the other factor to determine the proper line of flight on a cloudy weather. This is an ideal example for polarized light to detect the proper line for the lights in cloudy weather condition. Then next parameter, rainfall. Rainfall is essential for adult emergence of the cutworm, white grubs, and red hairy caterpillar. Means particular stages, means pupal stages hide in soil condition. Then rainfall, after rainfall, they requires some amount of water for the hatching the pupal stages and emerging the adult. Then heavy rain was the diamondback moth, aphids, and other soft-bodied insect. In heavy rainfall, the maximum soft-bodied insects are washed out. And less than 12.5 centimeter rain during summer season in the month of May and June. This result in increase in soil moisture, which is not favorable to the cutworm, and hence are forced to come out of soil and fall a ready prey to their parasites and predators. Is forcefully hatching their pupa and emerging the adults. On the other hand, if the rainfall is less than 10 to 12.5 centimeter during summer, they remain protected in the soil, and there can be a pest outbreak in next season. The intermediate low rain increase the brown plant hopper and thrips intensity. The desert locust does not lay eggs unless the soil has sufficient moisture, and further, even if it lay eggs, the eggs will not hatch until the sufficient moisture is present in soil. Desert locusts mostly prefer the moisture for egg laying as well as hatching the eggs. For example, mulberry silkworm, Bombax mori, they develop faster in light than the darkness. Then next example, a grub of Khapra beetles is Trochoderma granarium. They develop rapids in light than in dark condition. In moth of the spotted bollworm in cotton, Aria vitella, and red hairy caterpillar Amsecta albistriga lay most eggs during the period of the darkness. This moth prefer the darkness for eggling. Then when we will lay more eggs in total darkness than the daytime. Then next parameter, wind. Interference with the feeding or in wind blowing, this affects the insect feeding processes, mating, oviposition, and important factors for the dispersal of small insects, means movement one place to another place or away from their population. This aphid mite, is aerified mite, is dispersed through the wind. This is a soft body insect blowing with the winds or a heavy, highly blowing winds. Then topography, next parameter is topography. This mountain, lake, a river, sea act as a physical barrier for the spreading the insect. At the time of movement or migration, immigration, this is a mountain, lake, a river, and sea is the physical barrier for the spreading of the insects. And next parameter, soil type. This is a soil texture and structure can have a direct impact on the arthropods behavior and adaptations. This particular insect, they prefer the particular type of soil for their better development. Then certain soil insects such as the black wine, strawberry weevils and wild grubs are favored by the coarse structure soil. Then wireworm multiply in clay soil with poor drainage. Then wild grub and cutworm is a faster multiply in loam soil with good drainage. Then some organisms are specific type of soil or fertile soil is other preferred for the nitrogen fixation. Then next parameter, water current. It's standing water and running water. There is a different type of insect prefer the standing as well as running water. The larva of mosquito and beetles are able to live only in standing water. Means relatively low oxygen concentration water is a mosquito and beetles prefer for their development. In only running water is preferred the dragonflies and caddisfly, means relatively high oxygen concentration water required for further development. The dragonfly and caddisfly prefer the running water. And next parameter is nutritional factors. Every organism depends on plant for the food consumption. The insect are heterotrophics. Heterotrophics means this depends on the food for another. It cannot synthesize their own food material. They depends on the plant for the food consumption. Then the quantity and quality of the food also affect the insect survival. Then nutritional play the important role in survival, longevity, distribution and reproduction and speed of the development. Means quality and quantity of the food material, they depend on the all activities, survival, reproduction and speed of development. Then next part, effects of biotic factors on insect population. This is the previous part, is the insect abiotic factors and different parameters affect the insect survival. Then next part, biotic factors affect the insect population, means living things and dependent factors. The biotic factors, biotic components are the living things. Biotic components are the living things that shape and ecosystem. A biotic factor is any living components that affect the another organism. Means is dependent factors. Every organism depends each other. The biotic components usually includes producers. These are also called as autotrophs. For example, plants. They convert the solar energy into food materials or food. Then second, consumer. Also called as heterotroph. For example, animal, insects, they depends upon the producers for the food. And next part, the decomposer, detritivores orals. For example, fungus, bacteria or microorganisms, other microorganisms, they break down the chemicals from producers and consumer into the simple form which can be reused. And first producer. Producer means they use solar energy, then converted into food material. The sunlight is the main energy source for life on earth. Every life on earth, they require the solar light or solar energy. It's also called as autotrophs. They synthesize their own food materials. They use the light or chemicals energy to make the food. For example, plants, plant-like protist like, or protist is also called as algae, and bacteria, some bacteria, they synthesize their own food materials. And second, consumer, the organism that use food materials or energy of supply by plants is also called as heterotrophs. Means they does not synthesize their own food material. They depends on producers. Then carnivorous. Carnivorous means it only another organisms, and herbivorous, it only feed on the producers or plants. Then omnivorous, they feed on both plant as well as other organisms or animals. For example, feed cricket or earwing. Then decomposer, the main function of decomposer to break down the dead organic matters in reuse form. For example, protist, fungi and bacteria. Then energy flow from one tropic level to another tropic level, or one primary consumer, secondary consumer, tertiary consumer, then decomposer, and again reused by plants. It's producer. Then sun, solar energy use, solar energy and different chemicals you use to make their food materials in producers. Then after feeding the producer or energy transfer through primary consumer, then again energy transfer primary, secondary, tertiary and decomposer, and again reuse. Then classification of insect based on food requirements. Insect classify on the basis of food requirements, means different type of food material required for a specific group of organism. First, carnivorous type of insects feed on the both plant as well as animals or other insects. For example, wasp and cockroach. Then carnivorous type of insects. Carnivorous means feed on the other animals as a parasite and predators. For example, predatory ladybird beetles, mantids, then trichogramma or bracken wasp. And next the classification, herbivorous. They require the living plants as a food. For example, crop insect paste. Then another classification, polyphagous. Feed on the wide range of the cultivated and wild plants, means more than two. For example, locust, grasshopper, cutworm, then spotted Spodoptera lutra, means leaf eating caterpillar, then some pod borers like Helicorp armiger or American bollworm. Then another classification, oligophagous. The oligophagous type of insect feed on the plant belongs to one family. Only one family plant feed is called oligophagous, like cabbage butterflies or diamond back moth. And next classification, monophagous. Monophagous means feed on the single species of the plant. For example, paddy. For example, paddy stem borer, Scripophaga incirculata, brinjal, Epilgiana beetles. Then saprophytic type of insects, they require the food or decay organic matters like fruit flies and scavenger, fruit fly Drosophila and Cicidomyces flies. Then scavenger feed on the dead organic matters like how, for example, house flies and scarabid beetles. Then energy transfer from one tropic level to another tropic level through the up to the producer to decomposer. It's primary consumer, secondary consumer, tertiary consumer, and quaternary consumers. This is the energy. Our plant is the main producer. They synthesize their own food material. Another insect depends for the food materials. Means insects is the primary consumer. Depends for food material on plants. Then secondary consumer, tertiary consumer. The energy flow from the one level to another level is decreasing the energy to every tropic level. Then food change, or a series of step in which the organism transfer the energy by eating and being eating. Means every organism depends for food material to each other, and energy transfer one tropic level to another tropic level is a series of step to transfer the energy. This is the arrow going in a direction how the energy transferred. Means producer to herbivorous, herbivorous to primary consumer, then secondary consumer. This start from the producer and end with the consumer or carnivorous. Is the producer synthesize food material, then herbivore depends on plants. Then abiotic factor further divided into two different categories, means interspecific and intraspecific. Firstly, discuss with interspecific association. The interspecific association means interrelation between the organism of different species. This is the first symbiotic association. This is symbiosis, means the interrelation between organism of different species which live in close and long-term union without the harmful effects is known as the symbiosis, and each member is known as symbiont. Means two different species is a close relation and long-term union without harmful to each other. It does not harmful to each other, and this member is called as symbiont. Then one insect feed on the food collected by the another insect of the same species. For example, white ant, wasp, and bees. These are three different insects. They are different caste, means worker, soldier, and queen, king, or a drone. They mainly worker collect the food material, and other member feed on their collected food materials. Then symbiotic relation may be categorized in mutualistic, useful relation, then commensalistic. This is the again mutual useful relation, and parasitic is a harmful relation between the two organisms. First, symbiosis, any relationship in which the two species live close together. This is which represent the symbiotic relation. This is the honeybee require the nectar, then plant other hand, the plant transfer the pollen from stamens to stigma. Is the mutual relation between the two different species. The mutualism both species benefit. For example, insect and flowers. Means honeybee require the nectar and plant require the pollination or pollen transfer. Then commensalism. Is the one insect is benefited by living on or inside of the another insect without injury the other in other is known as commensalism, and is usually used to live on the waste or surplus food materials of the host. It not require the major food material, only surplus things or waste material of their host. Then another insect is survival on their waste part, not a harmful to their host. the benefiting the insect is called commensal, while the other one is called as host. When the two insect is a relation or live in close relation, then does not harmful the each other. For example, gall forming insects, then commensal use it host as means of the transport. This phenomenon is termed as the porosity. Then mutualism is when the association between the both the symbiont is known as mutualism, means benefited both partner to benefited to each other. For example, antenapids, then termite and flagellum, and antenapid ant secrete the honeydew like substances. Apid secrete the honeydew like substances. These honeydew like substances ant use for the food is a mutual relation. Then termite and flagellum is thermal in termite stomach. The flagellate use to convert the cellulose and cellulose in a gut. Then crow and cattle to pick up the stick and mites. Is a in ox or cattle feed on the garden or in grassland. Then different birds these present on their outside or their body. They use their ticks as well as grass insects. Then next classification is intraspecific. Intraspecific means same species competition between the or association between the same species. The aggregation, the tendency of some insect to concentrate in large number than found in normal distribution for mating and food. Means as normal distribution, then the aggregation is some insect secreted the specific chemicals to aggregate their other members. Then concurrence, the very large number of the insect crowded together in mass assemblage at one time for the hibernating, feeding or pairing is a specific purpose. The largely crowding the insects means concurrence. Then cannibalism, the insect feed on the individual of the same species, means one species member feed on each. For example, Helicobacter majora and Tribolium confusum, the larval stage and adult feed on their eggs. One Helicobacter larva feed on another larvae of Helicobacter. Then some adult also feed on their eggs. Then colonization, the group of the free living individual to form the colonies to have the better protection from the predators and environmental condition and improve the utilization of food material in making the colonies or a free living organism make the colony for their better protection. Means group the protect their natural enemies as well as predators. Then change in environmental condition as well as use the food material or better utilization of the limited food materials. For example, ant and termites. Then competition. The intraspecific competition, when the two organisms of same or a different species attempt to use the ecological resources in the same place at the same time, means limited food materials. The two different species or same species, they require the food material in some amount or limited food material. They compete to each other in species to species and species to another different species for food consumption. For example, food, water and shelter, these different things compete for each other. Food purpose, water as well as shelter or ovipositional site, they compete to each other. Then interaction between the organism. In competition, when the two organisms of the same or a different species attempt to use the ecological resource in the same place at the same time. And thank you.